Today we're looking at President Ulysses S. Grant. Hello, welcome to the Daily Bellringer. Please don't forget to subscribe and take a look at the questions down in the description. Ulysses S. Grant was the 18th President of the United States from 1869 to 1877 and was a member of the Republican Party. During the Civil War, Grant had become a national hero as he led the Union to victory over the Confederacy. Grant was born April 27, 1822 in Point Pleasant, Ohio. His birth name was Hiram Ulysses Grant and was the oldest of six children born to Jesse and Hannah Simpson Grant. His father Jesse was a tanner, or someone who made leather, and from a young age Grant learned the family business. As a child, Grant attended several different private schools and was a good student. But his true passion was horses. In his youth, Grant became known for his great skill in riding and handling horses. In 1839, at the age of 17, Grant was accepted at the West Point Military Academy in upstate New York. On the roster of students, there was a mistake listing Grant as U.S. Grant. The mistake was not corrected, and fellow cadets began to say that the U.S. stood for Uncle Sam, and so many began to call him Sam. The name stuck. While at West Point, Grant made many friends that later he would be pitted against during the Civil War. Two of his best friends were Frederick Dent and James Longstreet. Grant graduated in 1843 and was first stationed at Jefferson Barracks in St. Louis, Missouri. While posted there, he visited the family of his good friend Frederick Dent. Grant fell in love with Dent's sister, Julia. By 1845, the two were engaged, but turmoil in Mexico put their wedding on hold. Grant's regiment was dispatched to fight in the Mexican-American War. Grant served as a quartermaster, which is an officer that manages and handles supplies for the army. But he truly wanted to see action in the war. On several occasions, Grant distinguished himself for bravery. In one instance, at the Battle of Monterey, he volunteered to carry dispatches past Mexican snipers. He hung off the side of his horse, keeping the horse between himself and the enemy. In February of 1848, the Mexican-American War came to an end, and Grant returned to St. Louis. On August 22, 1848, Ulysses and Julia were married. They would go on to have four children together. After returning from the Mexican-American War, Grant began a typical military career, being moved from military post across the country. Grant moved to Michigan, New York, and then California. While posted in California, he was separated from his family. Grant became depressed, missing his family, and began to drink. Grant was found to be drunk while on duty and eventually resigned from the military in 1854 and returned to St. Louis, where he tried to farm but was unsuccessful. Grant's financial problems continued, and by 1860 he had moved his family to Galena, Illinois, so he could work in his father's leather shop. Grant was living in Galena when the Civil War broke out in April of 1861. Ulysses first aided in recruiting troops in Illinois, but soon was given the rank of colonel, and then by August of 1861 was given the rank of brigadier general. Over the next few years, Grant rose to be the most famous and heralded Union general, first winning victories in the Western Theater of the War at Fort Donelson and Shiloh, then taking Vicksburg, Mississippi, and securing the Mississippi River for the Union. In March of 1864, he was appointed General-in-Chief by Abraham Lincoln, giving him command of the entire Union Army. By the war's end, he helped lead troops to capture the Confederate capital of Richmond, Virginia, and accepted Robert E. Lee's surrender at Appomattox. All of his victories led to him becoming extremely popular, and many in the nation called for him to run for President of the United States. At the 1868 Republican National Convention, he was unanimously nominated to run with Schuyler Colfax as his vice president. In the general election of 1868, he easily defeated Democrat Horatio Seymour with 214 votes in the Electoral College to Seymour's 80 votes. Grant was sworn in as the 18th President of the United States on March 4th of 1869. Grant came into office in the midst of Reconstruction. He attempted to aid in reconciling the North and the South while at the same time protecting the rights of former enslaved people by stationing federal troops throughout the South. During Grant's presidency, there were several scandals or evidence of corrupt politicians profiting from the government, but Grant was never implicated in any of it. Grant helped establish the Department of Justice and signed legislation to designate Yellowstone as America's first national park. He was reelected in 1873 and soon had to deal with an economic depression that gripped the nation. Grant left office after two terms and then embarked on a two-year tour around the world with his family, meeting foreign dignitaries. Upon returning, he bought a home in New York City and invested his savings in a financial firm run by his son and a partner. The other partner stole the money, and in 1848, Grant went bankrupt. At about the same time, he was diagnosed with throat cancer. In the last months of his life, Grant spent his time writing his memoirs in hopes that after his death, his family could sell it to support themselves. Grant completed his memoirs and died just a few days later on July 23rd of 1885 at the age of 63. So with that, hopefully you learned something, and thanks for watching. All right, quick shout out here to the Edna Beatty 5th grade social studies class in Elk Grove, California. Thanks for watching.